हेलो गाइस, वेल्कम बैक। माई सेल्फ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर गौरांग प्रजापति फ्रॉम महात्मा गांधी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च सेंटर नवसारी। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द टॉपिक ऑफ डायरेक्ट एंड बेंडिंग सेस ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट स्ट्रक्चर एनालिसिस 1 फोर्थ सेमेस्टर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग। सो गाइज, दिस इज द फोर्थ वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। इन द प्रीवियस थ्री वीडियोज आई हैव कवर्ड द थियोरिकल पोर्शन इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो, देन इन द सेकंड पोर्शन वी हैव कवर्ड द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दिस मेसनरी पियर। ओके, इन द थर्ड वीडियो आई हैव कवर्ड द एग्जाम्पल्स रिगार्डिंग डैम एंड रिटेनिंग वॉल, एंड नाउ इन दिस फोर्थ एंड लास्ट वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द टॉपिक ऑफ चिमनी एंड मेसनरी वॉल। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द कंसेप्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल। सो जस्ट अ मिनट, या चिमनी एंड मेसनरी वॉल। So chimney and walls are subjected to wind pressure. Okay, so see over here, you can see in the figure, just a minute, say plan of the we can say cross plan is given to us, that is B cross D, and this one over here we can say elevation is given to us of the height h. Now this chimney or masonry wall will subjected to wind pressure, okay, as it is quite much at quite much high. Okay, so first of all we need to calculate maximum and minimum stress also in this one, like previous examples. Say sigma maximum and sigma minimum formula will be common, as like peers. Sigma maximum, that is sigma 0 plus sigma b, sigma minimum, that is sigma 0 minus sigma b, where sigma 0, that is direct stress, its formula will be, that is rho into h, where rho, that is density, and h stands for height. Okay, and on another unknown, that is sigma b, that is bending stress, that is always like m by z, where m, its formula will be capital P into h by 2, where capital P stands for wind force, and its formula is small p into small b into small h. This small p means wind pressure, that's b and h are the dimensions of the either chimney or wall, whatever given to us. Okay, so by using these formulas we are going to do the examples of chimney and masonry wall. Sometimes coefficient of wind resistance is also given in the example. So whenever this coefficient will be given, then we need to modify the formula of, we can say, P. Okay, then at that time this wind force formula will be C into the remaining term as it is P into small p into B into H, like that. That I will cover in the example. Okay, so let's start the example of this one. Say a masonry wall 6 meter high, is of rectangular section 3 meter wide and 1 meter thick. So in the plan I can show it, one B is 3 meter wide and 1 meter thick, that is taken as D. Okay, that's our, we can say, plan. Then a horizontal wind pressure of 1.2 kN per meter square, that will be acting over here, acts on 3 meter side. Find the maximum and minimum stresses. Take unit weight of the masonry, that is 24 kN per meter cube. It has been asked in 4 marks, May 2018. Now in this one, let's write down the data. Small h, that is height of wall, 6 meter. Okay. B, width of wall, that is 3 meter. H, thickness of wall, that is 1 meter. Okay, and that is D. Sorry, and P, that is horizontal wind pressure, that is 1.2 kN per meter square, and density is given, that is rho, 24 kN per meter cube, and we need to calculate maximum as well as minimum stresses. So now we know that maximum and minimum pressure, or we can say stress formula, will be common, sigma 0 and sigma b. So sigma 0 formula stands for rho into h, so we need to calculate rho and h, both are given in the data, so I will get sigma 0 directly, there is no problem with that one. Talking about sigma b, formula stands for m by z, so I need the value of m and z. So first of all, m formula stands for, that is p into, we can say, h by 2. That P means wind force, and its formula will be small p into B into H. Okay, so from this I will get the value of P, and I will get the value of M. And Z, that is section modulus, its formula will be, we can say, for rectangle section, it is BD squared by 6, or you can do, that is I by Y, moment of inertia divided by CG, you can calculate from that also. Okay, so first of all I will calculate sigma 0, that is rho into H. Rho 24 and height, that is 6. So 24 into 6, I got the answer, that is 144 kN per meter square. That's first stress as calculated. Now in order to calculate sigma b, first of all I will calculate z, that is BD squared by 6. We have both dimensions, width and thickness of wall. that is 3 into 1 square by 6, I will get the answer, that is 0.5. okay, then so I got the value of z. Now I need the value of m. In order to get the value of m, first of all I need to calculate the total wind force, that is capital B. Formula stands for small p into b into h. Small p, that is horizontal wind pressure, 1.2. b, that is width of wall, that is 3, and h, that is height of wall, that is 6. By simplifying the term, I will get the answer, 21.6 kilonewton. Clear? Now from this one I will get the value of m. Just a minute. Yeah, that is capital P into h by 2. Okay, now capital P, 21.6, and h, that is we can say 6 meter, so 6 by 2, 21.6 into 6 by 2, so I will get the answer, 64.8 kilonewton into meter. Okay, so now I can calculate finally sigma b, that is m by z. M, 64.8, and z, 0.5. so I will get the answer, 129.6 kilonewton per meter square. Finally we have got the value of sigma 0 as well as sigma b. So now I will calculate sigma maximum. Sigma 0 plus sigma b, sigma 0 144 plus sigma b 129.6, so I will get the answer, 273.6 kilonewton per meter square compressive. Clear? And then minimum pressure, sigma 0 minus sigma b, so I will get this answer, that is 14.4 kilonewton per meter square compressive. Clear? So in each of the examples of, we can say, masonry wall or chimney, we need to do the same procedure. What we will need to do, first of all we will calculate sigma 0. Rho and h both will be given in the data, so there is no issue with that one. But in order to calculate sigma b, first of all we need to calculate z, then we need to calculate wind force, and then from that I will get the value of, we can say, m, and from these values finally I will get the value of sigma b. Clear? And in the last, sigma maximum as well as sigma minimum, and they have not asked the diagram, but if we need to draw the diagram, so we will draw the diagram in the similar manner like in dam and retaining wall we were drawing. Sigma maximum on the right hand side, sigma minimum on the left hand side. Okay, like that. Okay, let's see another example. See, a masonry wall 6 meter high, so it is 6 meter, its solid rectangle section 4 meter wide, so B 4 meter, H 6 meter, 1.5 meter thick, so D value is 1.5 meter. Okay, a horizontal wind pressure 1.3 kilonewton per meter square, that means small p, 1.3 kilonewton per meter square, X on the 4 meter side. Find maximum and minimum stresses induced at the base if unit weight of masonry, that is 23 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, so we need to calculate sigma maximum as well as sigma minimum. So first of all, as we discussed in the previous example, sigma 0, that is rho into h, rho 23, h 6, so 23 into 6, so 138. Now in order to calculate sigma b, first of all we will calculate z, that is bd square by 6, b 4 meter, d 1.5 meter, so 4 into 1.5 square by 6, I will get the answer, 1.5 meter cube. Then in order to calculate m, I will need the value of capital B, that is small p into b into h. Small p, pressure 1.3, b, that is 4 meter, and h, that is 6 meter. By simplifying term, I will get the answer, 31.2 kilonewton. Okay, that's capital P. Now I can calculate the value of m, that is capital P into h by 2, capital P 31.2, and h, that is 6, 6 by 2, will get the answer, 93.6 kilonewton into meter. So finally I will get sigma b over here, m by z, m 93.6, and z, that is over here, 1.5. by simplification I will get the answer, 62.4 kilonewton per meter square. So finally we can say we have got the value of sigma 0 and sigma b. So now sigma max, sigma 0 plus sigma b, not minus sigma b, plus sigma b, so 128 plus 62.4, will get the answer, 200.4 kilonewton per meter square. And as it is positive, so compressive. Sigma minimum, sigma 0 minus sigma b, sigma 0 128, this one is 62.4, got the answer, that is 75.6 kilonewton per meter square compressive. Okay, and if we draw the diagram, sigma maximum is on the right hand side and sigma minimum, that is on the left hand side. Okay, so this is the example number 2. So now the next example, this is the last example of the chapter. Say, a cylindrical chimney 60 meter high of varying circular section, 6 mm external diameter and 2.5 mm internal diameter. Say, height of chimney, that is 60 meter, external diameter 6 meter, internal diameter 2.5 meter. It is subjected to horizontal wind pressure of 1.4 kN per meter square, that is small p. If the coefficient of wind pressure is 0.7, now this is new, this was not given in the previous two examples, that is coefficient of wind pressure, that is 0.7, and unit weight of masonry 20 kN per meter cube, that is rho. So we need to calculate maximum and minimum stresses. Okay. Now in the previous two examples, it were the examples of the masonry wall. Now this is the typical example of chimney. Say if I draw the plan, external diameter, internal diameter is given to us. Okay, in addition, height is given to us. If I draw the diagram like that, so that's height. And over here, pressure will be acting like that. This one is capital D, this one is small d. So everything is same except only P. So first of all, sigma 0, that is over here, direct stress, rho into h, rho density 20, height 60. So 20 into 60, I got the answer 1200 kN per meter square. Then in order to get the sigma b, first of all we need to calculate z. Now for the hollow circular section, we have already studied this one in the MOS, that is z equals to pi by 32 times d, capital D is to 4 minus small d is to 4. We have the value, capital D 6 meter, small d 2.5 meter. So pi by 32 times d into 6, in the bracket 6 square minus 2.5 is to 4. So ultimately I will get the answer 20.57 meter cube. Then this is the only change in the whole example p. Up till now we were taking p equals to small p into b into h, but in this one coefficient of wind pressure is given, so we need to multiply that coefficient of wind pressure, that is c. Okay, so capital P, formula stands for capital C into p into, instead of b this time diameter will be there, h is a circular section, into h. Okay, so c, that is 0.7, pressure, that is 1.4, diameter, outer diameter, that is 6, h, that is 60. So I got the answer 147 kN. Then from this one I will get the value of m, that is p into h by 2, p, that is 147, and h, that is 60. 60 by 2, I got the answer 4410 kN into meter. And finally from this one I will get the value of sigma b, m by z, m 4410, z, that is 20.57. so ultimately I will get the answer, that is 214.43 kN per meter square. And once I get this sigma 0 and sigma b, I can easily get maximum and minimum pressure. Okay, so maximum pressure, sigma 0 plus sigma b, sigma 0 is 1200, sigma b is 214.43. so 1200, 214.43 kN per meter square. As it is plus, it is compressive. Minimum, sigma 0 minus sigma b, that is 1200 minus 214.43. so I got the answer 985.57 kN per meter square. As it is positive, so compressive. They have not asked the diagram. If diagram is come, then we will draw diagram like this. At the right hand side sigma maximum, and at left hand side sigma minimum, both are positive, so diagram will be like this. Okay, so these were the examples regarding chimney and masonry wall. Hope so you have got all the concept of this chapter. Myself, Assistant Professor Gaurang Prajapati, signing off.